my pleasure to welcome you to our 23rd spring graduation. We have these programs here that allow students to get a degree and they don't have to relocate to Gainesville, which is a really good thing for our local area and students. Our teaching and research programs here on the Milton campus include natural resources conservation and plant science. We also have a campus south towards Allen County, if you know where that is, between Milton and Jay. We have a 640-acre research farm out there where we have researchers and extension faculty that work on turf grass, weed science, entomology, and cropping systems. The faculty you see seated here are the backbone of our programs. When they succeed, our center succeeds. I'm proud of them, and I do everything I can to make them succeed. As you can see, compared to Gainesville, we're pretty small, but we're really good. So with that, I'd like to introduce these faculty so you can get to know the folks that your graduates are, went to classes under. First of all, Dr. Debbie Miller, if you'll stand and remain standing until we get through everyone. Dr. Miller is a professor of wildlife ecology and conservation, and she's also our teaching coordinator, so the students see a lot of her. Dr. Matt Bedford is an associate professor of environmental horticulture, and he's also the lead on our plant science teaching program. Dr. Mike Mulvaney is an assistant professor, and he's a cropping systems specialist located out of Jay. Dr. Matt Deitch is an assistant professor, and one of our newer positions, he's a watershed scientist looking into water quality and so forth, and he's located here at Milton. Dr. Silvana Moraes is an assistant professor of entomology located out at Jay, but she also does some teaching. And Dr. A.J. Sharma, who's an assistant professor in forest resources, and he's located here, but he also does research out at Jay as well. So these folks work really hard for your students and so forth. And at this time, if you will, let's give them a hand, because they really work hard. There's one other person that I'd like to recognize tonight, and she works really hard for us as well. As you know, our programs are, this is Pensacola State, and we have two buildings on this campus, and I work closely with the dean here, and her name is Anthea Amos. Dr. Amos, would you please stand? As I said, Dr. Amos and I work closely together, and she facilitates our programs, and I can tell you it's a real good relationship, because I'm in her office asking her for something all the time, and I don't think she's refused me on anything yet, so we really appreciate what she did. So before we get to the important part, awarding the diplomas and so forth, I'd like to give a few words of encouragement and admonition to our students. Students, you've worked really hard to get here, and it's your work, and I really congratulate you. It's not a trivial thing to get a degree at a major university like the University of Florida. And also, students, your families and have supported and sacrificed. Anybody out there agree with that, that your families have supported and sacrificed to get you to this point? So it's been a joint effort. But all this sacrifice and hard work, it's really worth it. A degree from the University of Florida is a premier degree that's recognized all over the world. Something that you may not know, or you may have heard in the news, the University of Florida is now a top 10 public research university, according to the 2018 U.S. News and World Report Best Colleges ranking. And UF is now the highest ranked college in the state of Florida. So what's the big deal? What does this mean? For our students, attending a top 10 public university means their degrees will be worth more when they graduate. For our alumni who already hold degrees, the degrees they already hold are now more valuable. For the university, it means we're able to recruit and attract even more of the best and brightest students and faculty. For the state of Florida, it means our sons and daughters no longer have to go out of the state to attend a world-class university. For Florida's economy, having a top 10 public research university is an effective tool to recruit top companies and businesses. In terms of personal economics for you students, there's no doubt your earning potential is much greater from having attended the University of Florida. In fact, the estimates are that you're, over the next 20 years, you'll make $500,000 over that 20 years more than your peers that didn't attend college. So it's an economic boom for you. But it's not all about money, and it would be a sad thing if a college education is all about money. It's about more than that. There's a slogan that the University of Florida used to use. They don't use it right now, but the current slogan for where we push our overall programs is go greater. Get it, go Gator, go greater. But the old one I kind of like better. The slogan is for the Gator good. And some of you may know that to push our programs and support our programs a little bit, we have a grist mill, and we grind grits and cornmeal out there. And there's a blurb that I put on the bag, and I think it's really good for the students to hear, and it's something that exemplifies what a Gator is. And it goes like this. For the Gator good, for all 7B, moving forward and the whole world forward. Some people dream about making the world a better place. Gators are out there doing it every day. Through intellect and effort, Gators pull together. They inspire each other and move the world forward. The more impossible a challenge seems, the harder a Gator will work to overcome it. Whether it's advancing treatments for juvenile diabetes or protecting the orange crop, we approach every day with a singular purpose, one that's bigger than ourselves. Because we are Gators, always. So it really, being a Gator means something, students, and I hope you'll keep that in mind. So, go out and be a Gator and move the world forward, I guess is what I'm trying to get at. So, with those thoughts in mind, I'd like to move forward with the student introductions and presentation of diplomas. First up, Dr. Thetford, as I mentioned, he is our coordinator for our plant science program, and I'm going to ask him to come forward and present our plant science students with their diplomas.
Thank you, Dr. Wood. Well, at this time, I'd like to ask Amir Kelker if he would come on up. And while he's walking up here, I'm going to tell you that we are really excited to reach this day of graduation with Amir. Amir came to us with a background, trying to get courses in some animal science and things like this that he was doing at FAMU. And then he found our plant science program. And through our program, he was able to meld his interest in that side of science with what we do with plant science. And he's been working on his grandfather's farm for a while now, working with goats, working with crops, and doing a lot of the things that he had an interest in. So this is exactly what we are about here, finding a way for the students to get a degree that meets their career goals. And we're so excited that you've reached this end. Congratulations.
This time I'd like to invite Dr. Debbie Miller, who's our teaching coordinator and also coordinator of our Natural Resources Conservation Program, to come up and present the NRC graduates.
Great, we have a lot of them, so let's get right to it. Let's start with Emily. Many of our students, very hardworking. She has a family. She's an excellent student, and she's also, like many of our graduates, she's already found a job. And so, yeah, and not just a job, but like I'm going to miss Emily, I'm going to miss all of these graduates, they're all really great. And so, Emily, go, we can miss you. Congratulations. Oh, and I forgot to say that Emily Bagby has a 6-1. All right, next is Calvin Beach. And Calvin is the fish and duck guy, I guess is the best way to put it. He's going to be a great natural resource conservation for our water resources and our fish and our wildlife, and I'm really excited to send him out there because he's a great student. He works really hard. He's a lot of fun, which a lot of students are. He always makes us laugh, and he's going to be very successful. So, congratulations. Daniel Breathauer, who's also from Lauderdale, and he's also getting a minor in wildlife ecology and conservation. That's cool. Daniel, another great student, and not only that, but like many of our students, he's really taking advantage of what the University of Florida has to offer. So this summer, he's actually going to work as a research intern with one of our faculty. So that's really great. You ready to go out there and do it? Oh, yeah. Congratulations. Next, we have Anna Dix, a really hardworking student. And not only is she hardworking in the classroom, but we have a student club that every year produces a large number of plants, very large. And that is the way that we, the students are able to get some income. They sell these plants at our big flower festival here that they, some of you were here this spring. And Anna was one who produced with help the plants. So an incredible amount of work, and the money that we get from this is, goes to scholarships and lots of good things for students. So she provided the leadership, and that's really great. And so, congratulations. Hardworking students who work it's a full-time job. It's full-time, right? Pretty much? Not quite. But it's a job that may actually lead somewhere in your career.
Yeah.
So she's been finishing up her degree as she works, which is really a hard thing to do. Congratulations, and we look for you to do the same. And then there's Brian Schuman. How long have you been here, Brian?
20 years.
My entire career has been trying to get Brian through. Now, he's a great student. He just found the job that he wanted about 5 years ago. How long have you been there? 7 years ago. So, you know, then it was like, Brian, come back. You got to finish off. You got to finish off. He didn't see any reason why he had to finish off. He had a great job, right? So we finally convinced him to come back. His family convinced him to come back. And now his kids get to see him graduate. And we're just so happy about it. So congratulations.
For the moment you've all been waiting for, the last instruction from the University of Florida. Will the graduates for the Bachelor of Science degrees please stand? You may now move your tassels to the left side. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the latest graduates of the University of Florida. Let's give them a big hand. We appreciate your attention and appreciate you taking the time to come and wish these graduates well. So I'll ask that our graduates stay on the stage so that we can take some pictures. And that concludes our ceremony. So enjoy.